Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the vlog. Welcome back to the office. This is gonna be my office, and if you guys remember 2 months ago, I think it was, I ended up posting a video of called Creating My Office Space, and what I did was I painted these walls, which are now a grayish blue, darker tint to them. These things were like a mint green. I painted the ceiling, and then I ripped up the carpet on these floors, which is why we have so much echo going on in here. So now, over the past couple of weeks, I have spent so many days in here. When I pulled up the carpet, the floors weren't completely finished. They didn't have filler in between the wood slats, which ended up creating some issues. Could potentially create some issues. Let's air come up from down below in the crawl space, so it doesn't keep this room as warm as it potentially could. If any liquids get spilt or anything like that, everything would just go directly through, potentially ruining the wood itself. So what I did was I got some wood filler and I put in some work. Completely filled. I think it looks pretty good. It's gonna do the job. It's gonna keep airflow from coming from the crawl space underneath the house to kind of regulate the temperature here in the office. And everything looks sealed. It should keep liquids from seeping into the actual wood, doing any damage to the wood. So I think we're gonna be doing pretty good here. Now my goal is I would love to not have to buy a sander. I would love to not have to sand down this entire floor. It's just extra money, extra cost, extra time. Though I will, if I have to, because I'm already half-assing it, I definitely don't want to completely screw myself over. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a vacuum. This is set for over 24 hours now. I'm gonna take a vacuum, I'm gonna take a floor scrubber, I'm gonna take all these things and try and see if I can get it just cleaned up. Because it is quite rough, but it does come off fairly easy. If I were to lick my finger, I can rub most of this off. So I'm hoping that our little floor scrubber thing will actually pull everything up. I'm gonna give it a shot. I'm gonna get it cleaned up and see how it is. It's gotta get cleaned up anyways before I sand. So if I have to sand, I'll at least be ready for it. Floor, swept, vacuum. As you can tell, like, you see all those white splotches and stuff all over the place. That's just fingerprints and the chalk, molding, wood filler, kind of just all over the place. I'm hoping that this thing right here, this is just our floor scrubber that we use for our wood floors. It's got like a dual action, double scrubbing. It says that it's a Bissell, but we got this thing for like 30 bucks on Amazon. It was super cheap. I'm wondering if I go over it, I'm hoping it doesn't do damage to the wood filler, but I'm hoping if I go over it, it'll smooth everything out and just make it nice, because most of it is smooth. It's just the areas and where you see all this white stuff feels really rough to the touch, walking through here and stuff like that. I still have to lacquer the floor and I still have to end up doing a bunch more work, but if I can get this to smooth out and clean up by using the scrubber, ooh boy, we would be in business. All right, Scrubbers, I'm counting on you.
Oh, looks like it's kind of working. All right, we'll give this a shot.
Okay, so ultimately, it did clean the floor up, and it did smooth out a lot of the excess shit that was all over this ground. So, you know, that worked. I'm still not satisfied with it. This has already been probably 4 or 5 days or so. So it didn't get everything up. Now there was a lot of damage to this wood flooring originally. Paint splotches and other gunk and things that I still can't actually figure out what the hell it is or how it got there. I'm gonna have to sand this. That's pretty much what it comes down to. So a sander to rent through Home Depot or Lowe's is about $65-$70. It's a little tough just to rent for a 24-hour period. So what I did is I just ordered it ended up being $150 on Amazon. I ordered a hand sander, which is definitely not going to be as easy as one of those big push sanders, but it's something that we could use for restoring furniture, and we're working on a rocking chair downstairs and stuff like that, so we'll still be able to actually make our money out of it. You know, a sander's not something bad to have laying around the house when you actually need to use it. So after like 5 or 6 days worth of just physical labor, it was just taking the putty, putting it all over the ground, just trying to fill in these cracks and stuff. You know, there's tools and there's easier ways to do it, and you can hire people and all this stuff, but I'm literally doing it as cheap as possible. I got each one of those wood fillers for like $9 on Amazon. I think I went through like 3 or 4 of them. And then I had to make the decision. I really did. I tried to clean this up, but I ended up getting a sander. Now this is a DeWalt random orbiting sander. You can rent them from Lowe's and Home Depot and stuff, like the big ones, but this is such a tiny room, and to spend $65 on renting one for a day, and I may need it for 2 days or whatever, but then I never get to use it after that. So even if I was able to do this in 24 hours, which I probably could, it's just $65 that I could invest into something else, which is exactly what I ended up doing. And I'll be able to use this for other projects and stuff later down the road. So it's not like just a one-time use, but I ordered this on Amazon as well. There it is. There's the sander. Handheld sander, it's a 5-inch. Got a little attachment bag on here to try and collect as much as of the dust as possible. So I think something, charger. There it is. So this should just attach right on here. And just like that, it's gonna help keep this cleaner than what I would be able to do without it. My hope is not just to get the floor smooth, yes, but also to be able to take some of these top layers of like paint and gunk and stuff that was here when I ripped everything up and try and get those taken away as well. So I'm hoping it kind of cleans everything up and that it's gonna make it look good, but also get it back to a smooth feeling floor, so then I can be done with it. So I'm gonna try and sand that stuff, but then I gotta put it in like the shoe molding, and I've gotta put some finish on it, and just, you know, kind of finish these floors up. And I'm hoping I could do that sooner than later, because I really need to and want to get the office up and functional. I gotta get a desk set up, and I got so much stuff that I gotta do, and it's all being paused because of these floors. It feels really, really, really nice. So I've gotten just about in 10 minutes or so, that little square right there. Now, got a rest of a room to do.
whole bunch of dust. I did it. I freaking did it, and it feels pretty smooth. And I'm excited about that. Oh yeah. Oh, that feels. I'm sure I just got a bunch of dust all over me. You know, I'm pretty happy with the way that turned out. Probably took a solid 5 hours or so, 6 hours of handwork to be able to do this. But now I gotta let the dust settle. I gotta clean. I gotta get all the sand and all the stuff and all the dirt and dust and just, I gotta get everything up off this floor. So I'm probably gonna have to give it a good once through tonight with the little auto floor mop vac thing. Give it a good run through, probably one or two more times tomorrow. Do some vacuuming and sweeping and getting all those things up. But other than that, the sanding is complete. As you can tell, the floor looks incredibly dusty and, ooh, is that spilling over there? Maybe don't shake it. All right, I'll just let you be. So the floor is incredibly dusty. It's got white stuff everywhere from the wood filler. I'm hoping that a pass through with this floor scrubber, you know, it's got the dueling mats, I showed you guys earlier. I'm hoping this will go ahead and kind of clean up all the mess around here and make it look nice. That's what I'm hoping for. Now I may have to do this a couple of times, so we'll see. Doing DIY projects are always so hard because you set your expectations at a certain level, only to typically never meet those expectations. So. Can you tell where I cleaned? It's working. The floor looks great. I mean, that looks damn near brand new. Oh, I'm so happy. Of course, like I couldn't get up some of this. I don't know what it is. It's not even on top of the floor. It's like paint or maybe some type of primer, but this is gonna do exactly what I need it to do. So all of these, you know, these marks that I can't just get up, hopefully they'll all just disappear. I would love to even get this done today, but I'm not quite sure how that's gonna work. I'm gonna use Minwax. This is the wood finish here, and then I'm gonna apply a top coat with the polyurethane. I'm gonna go ahead and hit the baseboards with this duct tape here, just to be able to save the white paint that's around the bottom of it, just so I don't hit it with any of the wood finish. And then we're gonna give it a go. I'm nervous. We're almost down at the end, and I'm hoping it's gonna work as easy as I want it to work, but we'll see how that happens. All right, so I just got all the floorboards taped off. I'm gonna start probably in this corner right here. I'm gonna do like a little rectangle right here, let that sit for 5, wipe it up and see how it goes. So these fumes got a little heavy, opened up a window, turned on a fan. Now it's time to wipe it down and see how this first coat looks. All right, so this looks really, really good. I am super stoked, very happy with the way that's turning out. The color differences between over here, I know the lighting's all screwed up, but like this white, chalky, kind of pasty, pale, and then having this kind of darker wood over here, it may not come through on camera, but I'm really happy with it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lay out the first coat. I gotta let it dry for like 2, 3, 4 hours or something like that. And I might just do one coat, really just revitalizing, trying to even it out to what this looks like compared to what this is currently looking like. So, as long as this dries nice, cleans up nice, that was a lot easier than what I actually expected it to be. It just looks so much nicer, and I'm pretty happy with it. For my first at-home project, man, I have no complaints. So, I definitely have to go through, do all the flooring. It's probably gonna take me a little bit. I gotta do it in stages, just to keep myself from breathing in all these toxins and stuff. But yeah. Little 10-minute increments, and I think we're doing good. Okay, here it is. First coat is completed. Oh man, it's really shiny. It's got a cure for like the next 4 hours or so. I may just leave it all day. I'm thinking that it's potentially gonna be exactly what I want it to look like. It looks so nice that I might just do one coat on it. I might not even need a second coat. So I'm gonna let that sit and then we'll see what it looks like right now. And it's gorgeous. Wow, these floors look so nice. I am super stoked and happy, satisfied with, you know, the way that the color turned out. So now I'm down to the final couple of steps. Now I'm gonna lay down the polyurethane, which is just gonna be like the top protective coat over the wood here. I definitely are gonna, you know, it says let dry between 3 to 4 hours after final coat. Before light use 24 hours. This is gonna take a lot longer than what I thought it was gonna be. I'm about to lay down this first coat, let it dry, I guess 4 hours is what it says. Lay down a second coat, just to make sure that it's nice and protected. But then it's gonna take like a week before I can get in here and build the desk and everything like that. It takes that long to actually cure and that long to actually set. So I guess after a day or two, you should be able to light use, walk in here and stuff like that. But, and it's gonna take a little while, but I'm excited. We're in the final home stretch, so I guess I'm gonna get this going. First coat completely dry. For the most part dry. They say it takes about a week or so for it to actually cure, but we're definitely getting somewhere. This is it. This is all. I am now going to apply the final coat down on the floor with this polyurethane, and that's gonna be it. That is gonna complete my journey. Then I gotta let it set for a week. So yeah, let's get it done. And here it is, the final version of the floor. We are done. We are absolutely done, and I am so excited for that. There's still a little work that needs to be done in this room. I need to put quarter round molding down on the baseboards and stuff, but that's it. The floor is completely sealed. It has been a week since I put the polyurethane on top of the wood. The final coat, whatever it is, it feels so nice. I am super excited. Now we're at the point where they recommend give it 7 days, let it set, let it cure, let it be able to do its thing before you get in here and really do some work. So now it's gonna be putting in the quarter round molding. Now it's gonna be building the desks, installing shelving and sound panels and just all. Oh, I'm so excited and I'm so happy. Look at this. Oh my goodness. This floor looks brand spanking new. So I'm excited. I'm happy. I think that this has been a bigger project than I expected it to be, yet a more satisfying project than I expected it to be, if that makes sense at all. So, now that we are gonna be spending a few days trapped inside the house, we've been iced over here in Nashville. We got like 8 inches of snow coming, which is like gonna be record setting type of snow. I've got plenty of time to do some work in here. So now it is time to start building and hopefully take care of this echo. Yeah, it's annoying me. It's driving me crazy. I'm gonna go back and edit this for you guys to watch us and go, oh, I'm so sorry. But if you made it this far, thank you so much for dealing with the sanding, dealing with the painting, dealing with the just everything and this echo to put up with the video that I put out. I appreciate you guys so much. That's gonna go ahead and wrap up this video. The next time you guys see this office, it's gonna be putting things together, building, completing, just kind of slowly getting it to where I want it to be. So one more little lap around this floor. Oh my goodness, I'm really happy. So thank you guys so much for watching this one. I greatly appreciate it. Make sure to click that subscribe button if you have not done so already, because that's gonna notify you when I post new videos. And it's been kind of inconsistent lately. We're changing that, especially once this gets done. So I'm super happy with this DIY project of refinishing the floors, ripping up carpet, just painting walls, taking care of everything. Like, this has just been, I know this has been a couple videos long, but ultimately, this has been one of the biggest projects I've done in this house by myself, so I'm super excited about that. Thank you guys. We'll see you on the next one. Peace!